Hello everyone, Pani Coffee here. Today I'm going to share with you some ways that you can invigorate your motivation to build and paint. But first, coffee. Do you ever have days where you just don't feel like painting or building? Well, I can say you're not alone on that department. Everyone goes through that stage every once in a while. It's okay. And oftentimes we put so much pressure on ourselves to perform, to make, to create. You just oftentimes think that you're gonna sit down on your workbench and make something and you expect it to be great, spectacular, and that exceeds all of our expectations. Well, if you're watching this video, I think you realize that it doesn't work that way. Well, the first thing you might want to do is take a break, get distracted. Now, I should note that there is a difference between a distraction and procrastination. Now, what I meant by distraction is just do anything but the hobby. So do something else. If you like surfing, you like traveling, just do something else, you know. It can be anything from a coffee break to a vacation somewhere out of town or out of the country. Catch a movie, play video games, board games, card games. Like for my case, for example, I do a lot of writing. I play board games, video games, card games, anything else. Finding some inspiration from all of these other things that I'm doing. Board games, even video games, there is a lot of artwork in video games. I'm also flipping through art books. I love art books. You know, looking at somebody else's art in card games already with Magic the Gathering, for example, these cards always have stunning artwork and it's a great source of inspiration. I mean, color schemes, composition, everything under the sun, it's all in this small card. In movies, you have a lot of imagery, cinematography. It's a great source of inspiration. And while you are feeding yourself with this inspiration, you're also enjoying yourself. Your mind is having a rest, even though it's actually active, trying to find, you know, inspiration from everything around you. You're enjoying. So you are in a relaxed state. And soon enough, once you get back to your project, you might have fresh ideas. So, along with the motivation to continue, you can't catch a break. So, have a break. You can then slow down and organize all of your thoughts and all of your ideas. You know, when somebody tells you, let's take a look at this with fresh eyes, that's basically what it means. You know, take a break, organize your thoughts, rest. So, it's really important to take a break. Take breaks. It doesn't need to be a long one. Like I said, it can be a coffee break. It can be one day off. Just take a break. And then go back to it. Find inspiration. So this actually branches out from the first thing I've mentioned, which is take a break. Simply because by taking a break, you are opening up yourself to a lot of inspiration or or another hobby that you are interested in, or even from your dreams. I sometimes find inspiration from my own dreams, and when I wake up, I write it down. So as I've said earlier, you can find inspiration from video games, board games, movies, and even the places that you visit when you travel, or any other hobby that you're interested in. There's bound to be something that you can inspire yourself from and get back that spark of motivation. But perhaps the surefire way to go about this, since we're talking about hobby and modeling, is to find instructional books or even art books. You know, when you look at other people's artwork, you start to wonder or deconstruct how they achieve their masterpieces. You know, sometimes you see the brush strokes, like, ah, yeah, I see what they did there, that's a good idea. Or we could also be amazed at how some kind of technique or color scheme was used in a way that we never thought would be possible. So that's what I'm saying. Inspiration, you can find it mostly at other people's work, but also in other things. When you watch movies, movies have a lot of cinematography with them, art books, and you can see textures, colors, composition. That in turn could improve your own skill with regards to these concepts. And also at times we have some ideas that it's an idea. We know what we want to achieve, but we're not quite sure how to achieve it. Oftentimes you'll find the answer to that when you seek inspiration. So all of these things can lead you to find inspiration. Tidy up your workspace. Now I know some of you might say that you work better with this chaos around you. If that's where you're operating at your highest maximum efficiency, then you can skip this part. But if you're like me, so pretty soon enough after I've been working for a while, you know, you pull out tools, you pull out your drawers, and you take out paints, tools, your desk gets cluttered with all of these things, and just with all this chaos, sometimes you can't find things. You know, you misplace things because they're all over your desk. Well, at least for me, I can't function that way. The clutter is distracting. Don't make it arrive in a point where you can't find things, or you keep on bumping into something because there's no space anymore. And like I said, overall, the better you're feeling with your surroundings and yourself, the higher the motivation will be. And besides, if you tidy up your desk, you know where everything is. So just control the chaos. So here's a quote from a character of one of my favorite series. Every day, once a day, give yourself a present. Don't plan it. Don't wait for it. Just let it happen. It could be a new shirt at the men's store, a catnap in your office chair, or two cups of good, hot black coffee. Every once in a while, reward yourself. It doesn't need to be expensive. You know, buy a new pen, buy a new pair of socks, shoes, buy a cup of coffee. Just reward yourself. You know, buy new stuff. So, you know, get new tools, new paints. You want to try these new things that you bought for yourself and enjoy them, play with them. So that's one more way to boost your motivation. The better you feel, the higher the motivation will be. And you know, feeling good, this will have a positive effect on your work the next time you continue your project, or when you start a new one. So yeah, that's pretty much everything that I could muster for now. It's basically the things I already do when I find that my motivation is running low And also this can prevent you from being burned out from a hobby. Remember that the hobby is supposed to relax you. It's supposed to be enjoyable, not this stressful activity that you might not want to go back to ever. So anyway, thanks again for watching. I hope this video was helpful. I'd appreciate if you comment, like, and subscribe. You know, if you have any questions, simply hit me up in the comments and I'll try my best to get back to you as soon as possible. So that's it for today. I'll see you again next week. See ya.